Hey everyone, so this is the image we are going to be talking about today. As I mentioned earlier, this is the Dead Man's Fingers Run image. So as you can see, various elements all added in, composited in, colour matched and blended. So let's get down to the walkthrough. So this is me using some of my own stock images. So I started with the base. Because I knew I wanted the image to be quite wide along the bottom, I thought I'd take two separate ones along the same angle of the same place and then just kind of blend them together to give me a bit of a wider horizon and more to play with. So I'm just extending the canvas here and then cutting out the arm and the bottle from the images that I shot in the studio in York. York Photography Studio, it's a great studio. I work together with the owner in a collaboration using this studio. So this is me just using a pen tool to cut out the bottle. And in the image, that's one of my friends called Nick Hardy. Did a great job of holding a bottle of rum. So I'm just going through again with the pen tool, cutting out. So I shot this in the studio with a Fuji X-T3. So yeah, I'm just bringing it now over into Photoshop and just going through the stock images that I got. So I previously found some stock images before I started and I was just going to try and play around and see what I could get. But then I think as ideas came to me as I was editing, I went and found some again later. So this is one of the images here. So I just lined up both horizons of the images and then I knew I would have to extend the sky upwards. So what I'm doing now is cutting out some of the rocks at the bottom, and so my thought process of doing this was to create some foreground interest or some elements in the foreground that would be blurry. So I would blur them and they would have a little bit of depth of field. So I'm just cutting out the rock and then you will see me playing around and cutting out various rocks. Always with a pen tool. So go, just bring them across into the image. As you can see, then I think I did cut out this rock but then decided not to use it. Again with the pen tool. Just playing around the composition, trying to see what works and what doesn't work. Quite like the effect of the seaweed. I knew that once I dodge and burn and pull the details, it'll look pretty cool with the light on it. And it'll just be like extra detail in the image. I quite like composites where there's lots of little details for you to look around and keep searching the image and finding things and patterns. So this is a stock image from Adobe. This was the best I could find, I think, of the chest images, and I knew that the way the lighting was and that I could make it look realistic, and it will, because it's already, because it's CG, it already had like a stylized cartoony feel, so I knew I could play with that as well. So here I am. So what I've just done here is I brought in another cloud image, I put it over the top, I added a layer mask and then just blended in and out until it matched, and then I used curves to colour adjust the clouds at the top to match the colour of the clouds at the bottom. Then I just use perspective transform just to pull out the clouds at the top so it looks more realistic, that the clouds were getting wider as the more towards us what they were getting. And now just blending in and out of the horizon at the back, adding some atmosphere in. Now bringing in the ship. The ship is a PNG film. I think it was from Pixabay, and then I got the crabs from DeviantArt. Again, I like to bring lots of little elements in and try and blend them in and just add a little bit of interest for the viewer to keep finding. I knew that I wanted the skull in the clouds to match the skull in the bottle. Again, just roughly cutting it out, bringing it into the layers panel and then using a layer mask to blend out, and then I put that on, I think it was multiply or soft light, in fact it was soft light blend mode. And then I just added a little bit of a sort of colour match to it with a curves adjustment layer. Now I'll bring in the flag, which is seems to be a point of contention for everyone. Is it too close? Is it not too close? I like it as it is, but others don't, so there you go. Art is subjective. So what I'm doing now is just playing around with this skull. I think I do actually make that wider later. And now cutting out the flag. Bringing the flag in. Just adjusting the base images. So what I did here is I, for some reason, I just felt like switching the image was the right thing to do. So I just switched the whole image to the other side, like so. It just had a better feel to it. Sometimes you have to work from intuition, follow the rules, but also work from intuition. What's your gut telling you? What's your gut doing? So what I'm doing here is, in a second, is I've used a hue saturation adjustment layer. I've clipped it to the hand, to the bottom of the hand, and what I'm doing now is I take this little hand sampler here, click it onto the skin tones, and then I change the hue. And I change the skin tone from like the pinky reds to the green, because obviously I'm going to change this hand into a zombie or undead hand. So now just using the full check to match saturation of the various elements, pull down saturation and just check the hues of the image. Now just blending in this area a little bit better, painting in the blues, bringing in the foreground elements, using a Gaussian blur to blur it out to get the depth of the field. Now I'm just going through the various elements and color matching with curves, so we've got through the chest and the rocks at the front, the foreground, the boat. Now I'm just bringing in the waves hitting the boat, the sunken pirate ship. Just going through the tonal, so again, curves adjustment on the chest here is just darkening certain areas and brightening certain areas. Now bringing the splashes to the foreground and blur, put some motion blur on so it looks like the hand's rising out of the, like some kind of rock pool. So the image is starting to take shape now. Zooming in. Now I've added some fingers from the guy to the top of the rock, so it looks like actually maybe the undead guy or the zombie pirate is kind of laid in between these rocks in a rock pool. Maybe he's brought one hand up onto this rock to pull himself up, and then he's lifting the bottle up with the other arm. And now to get the undead or the decayed skin, zombie skin, whatever you want to call it, all you have to do is use a stock texture. So decay stock, so it can be like cracked walls or rotting wallpaper or even rotting veg and meat. And I just brought the stock image over and switched it to soft light blend mode, and it just blends in with the skin. And then I use a layer mask just to mask it off the areas I don't want to. You'll need to be a little bit more precise with this as well. You need to be precise, should I say, when you're masking. So I do it roughly, and then I zoom in and adjust everything. As you can see here, some of the edges are perfect, so I do go over and zoom right in and start with just a brush on a really low floor, start brushing away all these little areas that don't look that good of them on the masking. So there's never, I don't believe there's a very quick, perfect way of masking. There's always adjustments you need to make, or refinements. So yeah, just go in and you can use a brush to refine the edge what you've already got. So again, now just adding textures to the fingers. It's like a sweat room in here today. The English weather is glorious. They've got the sun coming down to me and I am sweating my tits off. I need to get a cold shower. Anyway, so still refining the edge of the mask, and now going to the skull, and I use guidelines then just to make sure it was in the center. Now I had the idea of adding some like drops, like moisture, or like maybe little drips from the sea. What I'd kind of say, if we were looking through a lens and shooting this image, and then the moisture was affecting the lens, or little bits of water had hit the lens, I kind of wanted that effect. Just gently put it in at the bottom. People may not have noticed it, or they may have noticed it, but no one's mentioning it, so who knows. So I'm just refining the masking on the chest and the crab. So as well, I don't know if I've gone over this, but I just used a cloud brush just to add the atmosphere and the sea mist along the horizon here. Again, it's also good for creating separation from the background, from the foreground and the background. And it also makes it easier to blend in the ship. Sometimes composite is about hiding things and just kind of play with what you've got to make the scene look more realistic. And we did, we killed two birds with one stone then, because we got the sea to look realistic, so they've got the sea fret coming off the sea, but then also we could hide certain parts of the boat. So now just adding texture to the foreground fingers. Again, then blurring them. So now we've got all the texture done on the hands, we've got the texture on the fingers. Now we are dodging and burning the image with a curved dodge and burn as always. I always dodge and burn every image, and if you watch my tutorials you probably already know that, so there's no point in going over it because I've gone over it a million times. So now I'm just adding more light to the seaweed here because I think it looks more stylized. Refining the mask on the chest and the golden around the, just in that general area. Dodging and burning again, and similar will be onto the colour grading and styling. Create a shadow now, just to create a duplicate of the crab, using levels to turn it completely black, and then using that second layer, duplicate layer, as a shadow for the crab. And dodging and burning the hands. Now adding in some light flare here from the beginning, then you all want it the light to crack through this little bit of sky here where it was already coming through a little bit. I was just going to add some more and stylize it. So again, linear dodge on a blank layer, just painted it in with a white brush. I selected like the brightest area from here, which was nearly white, just a hint of blue, and painted that over and linear dodge. And then again, as I have done many times, I used some overlays. These ones again were from Pro EDU. So I've used these on so many images now, you should be able to see how handy these things come in. So go check out the overlay packs on ProEDU's website. This is another ProEDU overlay. Just adding in some orange light flare. So my thought on this is there's a lot of blue in the sky, and then I think overall I give the image a blue colour grading, if you remember. So the complementary colour of blue is orange, so I thought it'd be nice to have the complementary orange in the light. Again, now I'm just doing the colour grading. So I added the colour grade, and then I also added some colour in the shadows. So let's just go back a couple of seconds. So that's the light flare. Then using colour effects to add some clarity. And then what we do is, that was the gradient map coming up. So yeah, I kind of use these blues here, so a not turquoise, but going towards turquoisey blue for the gradient map. And for the colours, I added some reds into the shadows a little bit, which I was just really adds that pencil feel to images. And now I'm just trying to game with the moisture and the drips on the lens glass, or supposed lens glass, as you can see here at the bottom. And I just do lower them down with the opacity. I did decide against using it at the top as it was a little bit distracting, so I hid them in the shadows a little bit down at the bottom. Then a little bit more dodgy burn, and that's basically the final image. So what I did after this is I sent that off and just got all the, I got it cleaned up by a retoucher who is Sue Rocks, also known as Susan Rockstraw, who's an amazing retoucher. And once that was done, I just added some sharpening to the whole, locally to certain parts and then globally to the image, and that was the final image. So I hope you enjoyed watching how this image got put together. This is one of the favourite of recent images to create. I had so much fun creating this, and I feel like there's certain things that I kind of levelled up on. And also there's certain things maybe that next time I look at. For me, the flag, I think it's perfectly fine as it is. There's a lot of people who didn't like it because they were saying it was too close to the hand. For me, it's totally fine, but I think sometimes, like, if the image is too perfect, like if it was exactly symmetrical to the boat, I mean, I don't know if it would have taken away or if it would have made the image better, I'm not sure. But my thought is, it's always good to create create shapes in your images sometimes. So a triangle is always a good shape to create. So you've got a triangle here, then you've got a triangle coming up from the boat, up the nose, back down here, again with the flag across. And you kind of got a triangle here with the skull. So that's my thinking. Maybe it's wrong, maybe it's not. Art is subjective. I mean, I always like people's opinions. So I'm glad that people are giving me their thoughts on it, but again, also, if I'm okay with something what's in the image and I create the image, then that's all that matters, really. But that's the fun thing about art. Everyone has opinions. No one's right, apart from maybe the person who's created the image. But there we go. So that's it for this week. Feel free to leave comments below in the YouTube, and I will speak to you later. Peace!